Hey ADF fans, welcome back to the channel. Today I want to talk about a few new features that we've landed recently in Azure Data Factory, and I want to put them together into a single demo pipeline so you can see how to use them in your pipeline patterns. So let's start by looking at the pipeline I have on my screen right now. So a very simple pipeline. It's for this demonstration, it's going to use three new features. The first one is the assert transformation, mapping data flows so I can set expectations, data quality rules in my data. The second is an update to an existing expression function within mapping data flows called column names, where I can now add an additional optional argument onto the column names and ask ADF to only return columns that are drifted columns. So I'm going to use this to look for schema drift. If there's schema drift, I'm going to consider that an error, and I'm going to then go down the bottom path of my workflow here, and I'm going to execute the SQL scripts using the script activity. My SQL script is going to be an ad hoc insert. I'll show you that right here. That is over here on my script activity. It's going to insert a row into a log table. So using this SQL script activity for logging inside your pipelines is a great use case for the scripting. All right, let's double click first on the data flow. So the data flow is a very simple set of transformations in it, and it's really just for this demo. So I'm going to bring in some product data. I'm going to set my assertions and expectations, and at the end I'm just syncing it to a cache sync just so that I can make it a valid data flow. I'm not really going to do anything with this data. By the way, setting a cache sync is great to put kind of that stub in your data flow just so you can publish and you can test with it. So I have five columns. As long as those columns are all present in the data, there's no drift. If another column is added, then it will be considered schema drift. Just to show you the data real quick, it's just two products that I've set here in my CSV file with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the columns are already there. So there'd be no schema drift the first time you run this. Now let's look at the assert transformation. What I do is I set and expect I'm expecting this expression to be true for the assert to pass. So what I'm saying is I'm going to use the new column names updated function where I'm going to send a second parameter saying true. Column names returns an array, and by saying true as a second argument, it's only going to return columns that are drifted columns. So I don't really care about what columns are drifted. I just want to know whether it was I want a binary answer here, a yes or no. Were there drifted columns? So what I'm doing is I'm checking the size of that array. Size is the function within the ADF mapping data flow data transformation functions to get the size of an array. So I'm going to assert that the size is going to be 0, which means that this assert is going to pass. For it to fail, there has to be some schema drift. I'm calling my assert, assert no drift. Now, let me just actually execute. Well, actually, I already have the data preview here, so you can see that this shows that there is no schema drift in it. If you want this pipeline then to execute down the failed path, you must fail the data flow. So there is an option on the assert, on assert settings called fail data flow. When I click this and there is schema drift, you'll go down the second path and write to your log file. Let me just quick put this back to no fail so I can execute this in data preview design mode here. And let me go back into the file. I'm gonna set another column on here. We'll call this column as, let's say we're looking for maybe size. And we'll set two sizes on here. We'll set a size of medium, and then we'll set a size of large on your M&L. That's good enough. Go ahead and save it. Let's go back to the data flow. And we're going to, this is a little trick. I might have shown this in other videos, but if you haven't seen it, I'll show you here. You can invalidate the cache so that the data flow that's in memory from the cluster that's being used here for your data preview will reset the cache. I'm going to rename my source transformation. Now if we go back, we look at the data preview, refresh that on the assert, we should now see that Data Factory has detected drift in these rows. Now you'll be able to send that to your pipeline and say, there's new columns that are coming into this data, and I do not want those. I want to log that into my SQL table. So you see if they show up as red or error. So let's go back to the assert settings. Now that we tested, everything's good. We're going to set fail data flow if that's the case. It is the case now. So what will happen is if we go over to our pipeline, we can execute this now in debug. And what will happen is we'll go through those two rows within the sample data. And we're going to find that there are drifted columns in there, and it's not going to like it, and it's going to send it out to our error table. So while this is running, let me bring up the SQL Server, and we execute that query, and we do see that we have our error row was inserted into our table through the script activity in the pipeline. If we go back to the pipeline, we'll see that the data flow failed, and then it wrote to the log table, which we saw. And if you look at the error within the data flow, you'll see that in fact our assert node drift was the reason for the failure, so our assert failed. And there you go, that's how you can use those new features within Data Factory. Thanks for watching, see you next time.